Butch?
Yeah.
Tell me how you're doing tonight.
I'm doing pretty good.
Tell me a story. Tell me about anything about your past, about your jazz past and music.
Well, I was incarcerated in a mental institution for quite a while.
And tell me why that happened.
Why it happened, it was just, I worked over at Blues Alley, you know, and, it wasn't exactly, you know, the air conditioner and, you know, all this going on in Blues Alley. And I got fired because I had a stick of pot. And then I started getting sick, you know, things were going, cars were going in all different ways and everything like that. And so I heard voices talking to me, you know, but it was a, police talking out of the microphone. So I went on in and I had to go to court. And the judge said not guilty. And I went in there on a divorce. And I just didn't go back. And then I stayed in there and practiced and went to school.
And you got a degree.
I got a degree from American University.
While you were at St. Elizabeth?
While I was in St. Elizabeth, yeah. They gave me a good participation. Participation. And I hung that on the wall.
Tell me about playing music at St. Elizabeth's.
Oh, we had a guy, this bebopper, you know, he was working there behind the desk. And he played trumpet. His name was Aubrey Twyman, and he came up with Charlie Rouse and one of Dizzy Gillespie's, you know, but he worked at the Pentagon. Then he lost his job at the Pentagon and he got a job out there playing trumpet. So I stayed out there with him and practiced with him, you know, and went to school, you know, and it's kind of rough out there.
Tell me about your life in a mental institution and the life outside of the mental institution. What's the difference?
It's a big difference. You got to get used to being in the street, you know. You know, because you got to be sure to take your medicine. Because people will take advantage of you if you don't take your medicine. So, that's about it. That's about it.
Because you've said to me sometimes you think about going back to rest. What do you mean by that?
Oh, did I say that?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I asked my doctor, could I come back to Springfield? I was in Springfield Hospital, St. Elizabeth's, and then I went to Springfield. But only thing about that, they cut you off your check, you know, if you're going to stay there, you know. But then they told me I didn't have Medicaid, but I do have Medicaid because they paid my bill at a hospital, you know, in Prince George's County. But he looked at the records. I went back up there, you know, trying to get back in. But they did about all they could do for me, you know.
You said you were in the Army?
I went in when the troops were coming back.
From where?
From Vietnam. That was in 71 or 72. And the records got burnt in St. Louis, Missouri.
And were you in the Army in the Washington area?
Yeah, in the Washington area, yeah.
And where did you serve?
They sent me. The troops were coming back. I didn't have to serve.
Thank you. Oh,